Welcome to the video series, The Operational Amplifier, From Abstraction to Reality. This video is about a problem with op-amp decoupling circuits that can resonate and serve to amplify noise into the op-amp's power pins. Let's begin by looking at the power supply rejection ratio spec again. This is a typical spec with a whopping 130 dB typical rejection. That's definitely a wow factor. Converting from dB comes out to only 320 nanovolts per volt. That's amazing. Well, one thing they don't often advertise in the PSRR specs, unless otherwise specified, is that it's relative to the input. It's actually the amount of input offset voltage change with power input change. Therefore, to get the change in the output voltage, you must multiply it by the noise gain. If the noise gain was 101, the output could change 32 microvolts per volt. That's still really good, but there's another problem. The power supply rejection ratio degrades with increasing frequency. Some op-amp datasheets do not even have this chart. The PSRR for the plus rail is usually a different characteristic than the negative power input at high frequencies. Note here, the rejection is 0 dB at 10 MHz for the positive power input. You are likely to have some switching power supply noise in this spectrum, and the op-amp will have no inherent rejection to it. It's imperative to do a good job filtering and decoupling the power for op-amp circuits. Here is a common vanilla decoupling network comprised of a series inductor and shunt capacitor, aka a two-pole low-pass filter. It should work great. Here I've simulated the parasitic elements of the inductor with some series resistance. It will have some parasitic capacitance too, but it's usually negligible. I modeled the typical effective series resistance and effective series inductance of the shunt capacitor. The source and the load may have some additional parasitics as well, but for demonstration purposes, I think an ideal source and load will suffice for demonstrating the problems. The 10K resistor just represents the DC load of the op-amp. Here's the AC response. At resonance, between the L and C, we get a massive 30 dB increase at 500 kHz. This is because the Q of the inductor and capacitor is very high. With only 50 milliohms of DC resistance, the Q comes out to 62.8. What this means is, if there's noise in this part of the spectrum, it will get amplified by this resonance and applied to the op-amp's power pins. Since there is little rejection in that part of the spectrum, combined with some gain, the power supply noise on the output could be untenable. Let's juxtapose the decoupling AC signal response with the PSRR plot, lining up their horizontal axes from 10 Hz to 10 MHz. The PSRR of the positive supply at 500 kHz is only about 42 dB. If there is noise in the spectrum near the resonance, in addition to the poor PSRR, another 30 dB comes out to only about 12 dB of power supply rejection. The LC resonance is very problematic. Let's just take the inductor out. We will just use the circuit board trace to connect between the power source and the shunt capacitor. I'll use my handy dandy Microstrip inductance calculator. It shouldn't be much inductance. With a length of 1/2 inch and a width of 20 mils, we get only 7.5 nanohenries. Based on the copper cross-section, I gave the microstrip trace an 8 milliohm resistance and the calculated 7.5 nanohenries inductance. This gives us a 32.2 dB spike at 18.4 MHz. The Q comes out to 577. It would be even worse if it weren't for that 10K load resistor. You can run, but you can't hide from inductance. By removing the 1 microhenry inductor, all we did was to replace it with a smaller inductance. The smaller inductance value with even a higher Q. The way to remedy this problem is to reduce the Q of the network. Let's go back to the 1 microhenry decoupling network and add a 10 ohm series resistor. That eliminates the resonance, resulting in a 40 dB reduction. It's technically damping, but some people call it DQing. In the case of the capacitor and the microstrip trace, playing around with various resistance values in the simulation, it only took 2 ohms to damp that resonance by 40 dB. I say to always have at least a circuit board provision for series resistance in the decoupling network. If you are driving high current loads and the resistance seems to be too much, consider ferrite beads. If your power is clean and you need to drive high current loads, you can always put in 0 ohm resistors. In summary, power supply rejection specs are deceiving. They are great at DC, but not so good at higher frequencies. Keep in mind, the decoupling resonances are really only a problem if the noise in the power line exists to amplify. Keep in mind that noise may be very low in your test environment, but your circuits could be susceptible to radiated fields and other environments. It's all about the Q of the circuit. The L and C values just tunes the resonance. Always leave a spot for series resistance. You can always populate it with 0 ohm resistors if you don't need it. Thanks for watching. Please click the like, subscribe, and notification bell so you don't miss any upcoming content.